Hey everyone, I thought I'd make a super fun video where I try to recreate a Miley Cyrus look. Everyone seems to stop me constantly out in public and tell me how much I look like her. It's one of those scenarios where someone taps me random on the shoulder, or a random person taps me on the shoulder, and is what ends up happening is they start off by saying, "Oh my gosh, do you know who you look like?" And before they even finish what they're saying, I'm saying Miley Cyrus, or one of my friends that I'm with is saying Miley Cyrus, because I already know what y'all are thinking, because it happens all the time. For the last 6 years, this has been happening. Ever since her Hannah Montanna days, this has been happening. So I want to know what you guys think if I was able to recreate this look, and if y'all lovely people want to know how to create this look, stay tuned and I will show you. You guys, I picked this photo up here to base my look off of. It's one of those photos that I asked my friends for their opinion, and they said that this photo looked most like me. So, here we go. Let's get started. I'm going to be starting with Roche-Posay, my favorite moisturizer that I like to prep my skin with. I don't really like to use primer simply because I don't want to penetrate my pores and get pimples. So I always start with a really good moisturizer to sort of create that barrier. Baby. Once we've gotten some good barrier lotion on your skin, I'm gonna go ahead and use BB cream by Maybelline, and it is the Dream BB Fresh. It is fabulous and super light, perfect for this look, because it's super, super dewy and very light looking. It looks like she almost walked out of her house with no effort, which is exactly what I'm gonna try and recreate. Baby. Are you listening? As you can see, it just added a little bit of color. The good thing about wearing this is there is a little bit of SPF in it, SPF 30, so if you're going out with this look for the day, it's fabulous. For me right now, I'm just trying to look as much like Miley as possible. So after that, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with some of my concealer because I need to brighten up my eyes, and I know I have some zits that I need to cover. So I'm just gonna hit my nice good old T-zone and wherever the little things are that I don't want people to see. My concealer that I use is Maybelline Fit Me in Sand. Now that I finished blending that concealer in with a good old little triangular sponge, they're my favorites because they're disposable, therefore, once again, preventing pimples. And now I'm gonna go ahead and move on and use my loose powder. I will be contouring today with powders because I'm trying to recreate that super natural look. The loose powder I will be using is by Maybelline. It is the Shine Free Loose Powder in Light or 01. There it is, and there it is. That loose powder did a really good job of soaking up that extra oil on my face. Since I used the BB cream, it will probably get oily pretty quickly if I'm gonna be outside or if it's gonna be a long day. I wouldn't really recommend using BB cream if you're naturally oily and you like are in a hot environment or something, or you're going out for the night and you're planning on dancing. Not a good idea, my friends, but this is something where you could use it for the beach. But for this look, I'm just trying to recreate it and get it as dewy and natural as possible. So after that, I'm gonna go ahead and use my Bare Minerals, and this is called Warmth. Yes, Warmth. It is a loose powder. I use this a lot to contour and also kind of like as a bronzer, I guess you could say, you have to be very, very gentle with the product. I mean, I literally usually just end up using what is in my lid simply because it is so pigmented. And if you use a lot of it, you end up just totally ruining your whole base. So I just went in with extremely light. Like I said, literally I used what was in my lid and I didn't even do one of these numbers. So after that, I'm going to go ahead and use some of my blush, which I will be using Mist Stockholm. And this blush is, I believe, called Natural. I wore it off, unfortunately, but I don't know if you can see the color very well, but this color is super amazing for warm or cool because it's a bit of a neutral tone. My skin is cool. And this color ends up looking fabulous and very, it like just brightens me up, gives me life. So I've just finished my base for my face. And then I'm going to go ahead and do my eyebrows. And today I'm going to be using my Morphe palette for brows. I don't remember the specific. Oh, it's brow 8. I definitely cracked one of them. And so my palette looks like a mess. So don't judge me, but this is what I'm going to be using. These two here. As you can see. Total disaster zone. I refuse to clean it up because I just keep it in my bag. Call me lazy. I will be using a nicely slanted brush, an angled brush, just so I can get that really fabulous straight brow. I ended up tweezing my brows a little bit to try and get the Miley brow, but I'll be honest with y'all, I'm probably not gonna get it exact simply because her brows are just shorter and more pointy and her eyes are like bigger here. So like there's actually features that we're like very different on, but apparently everyone seems to think we're so similar. And I won't lie, there was one time I did fully believe it, but I can tell are definitely a lot thicker, different shape than hers. But like I said, I'm not gonna tweeze my eyebrows all the way off because I don't think my brow, I don't know. I appreciate Miley's straight brow. I think it's amazingly fashionable and she rocks it like no other, but I tried. I really tried. Now that I've nailed my brows, or tried to therefore, I'm going to go ahead and move on and do my eyeshadow. The eyeshadow I'm going to be using today is NYX, their Jumbo Eye Pencil, and in 611, which is called Yogurt. I actually kind of use this almost as a primer. It is a cream to powder, so I usually just kind of smudge it all around and then use my big old brush, shadow brush, or blending brush, to blend it all in. Once you get that all blended in, I'm gonna go ahead and go and use Miss Stockholm Color Vibrations. It's a pretty like white shimmery with gold glimmer. The Color Vibrations from Miss Stockholm are fabulous. I love them. Baby, can you hear me? As you can see, it really gives it a little bit of dimension. I ended up putting a little bit on my brow bone, but basically focusing main on the center just to give it that little bit of pop. And now for the challenging part, because we all know how much we love using liquid eyeliner. Especially this look. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I rarely use liquid liner. When I do, it's like not the wing, because one of my eyes is a little bit wonky compared to the other eye. So like usually is what ends up happening when I put liquid liner on myself or I go for the winged eye. It ends up just taking me way too long. I don't got time for that. And on top of the fact that like one's always different than the other, I know I'm not alone in this, but I'm gonna try my best. All right, so for the liquid liner, my favorite is NYX Matte Liquid Liner. Sometimes I end up using a tiny, tiny little paintbrush because sometimes that will help, but I will use this today, I believe, unless I really struggle. Because her liner in this photo, it's very, very thin. So I'm hoping for the best. Can you hear me when I'm crying out? Okay, so now that I finished with my eyeliner, as you can see, I did a very, very subtle wing. I tried to keep it as thin as possible. Like I said, this eye closes a little more than this eye, so I tried to make it a little bit even based off of that. Everyone's eyes has their own certain shape, so if you're mimicking this look, be aware. So, I feel like I did a decent job, yeah? Now that I have that finished, I'm gonna go ahead and go and use my Colossal Mascara by Maybelline. So scared, but when you're near me, I feel like I'm standing with an army of men. And that does it for the eyes. The last thing for this look is my lips. So for my lipstick today, I know in Miley's photo, she lined her lips and then probably went in with a lipstick over top of her gloss because they look very glossy. I'm not gonna do that approach. I'm actually gonna do something a little bit easier. And I picked Melted Chocolate by Too Faced. And that does it for the makeup. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do my hair to complete this look and hopefully convince you guys how much Miley and I are twins. All right, so for my hair, I ended up just letting my hair dry normally, and I ended up parting it and in the similar area. It seems like she has a pretty harsh part. And down the right side of my head, I don't know if this is, I think I'm doing it backwards to be honest, but I'm looking in a mirror. So I did it on my right side and I already parted it, and I'm then gonna go in with my hair clip and section off this top part. Oh yeah, that's a good look. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just use a half inch curler to just one curl the end here. So I'm actually gonna go back in and bring this down. now I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my Tresemme hair gel. It's the Extra Firm Control. I'm actually gonna let this dry. Just be sure if you're using a metal clip like this, I would use like something to go over it, but if you're using a metal clip like I am, just be sure you don't put it on the gel portion. Push it a little bit back to be on the dry section, or else it's gonna leave a dent or a mark. Okay, so I let that sit for about 5 minutes, and now that I've let it dry, I have my final look. So I have full glam face, full hair, as best of my ability to try and match the lovely Miley here. So, ladies and gentlemen, what do we think? Do you agree with everyone that seems to stop me and are so convinced that I'm Miley? If so, guys, please go ahead and give this video a like if you agree. I so appreciate all the support and love. And especially if you guys go ahead to my channel and hit that lovely subscribe button so you guys can see more tutorials and videos coming soon.